I made love to an older woman one time. They call them cougars now. Back then, I just called her Aunt Donna, to be honest with you. I had no idea what was going on, but that's... She was more of a leopard, really, you know. She had a lot of liver spots. But let me say this. Let me say this. Relationships. Relationships are tough, and I got a buddy of mine right now, and I feel bad for him. His blow-up doll popped last week, and it's pretty tragic. I guess he was making love, and her face hit a carpet tack. And, you know, it's on YouTube if you want to see it on there. I love you, I love you. She went farting out the window on him there. And he's trying to mend the relationship now, but he says she ain't as attractive to him no more. You know, with the eye patch and everything. It ain't saying anything. There's some kinky folks, too. I got a buddy of mine into wife swapping. I might try that. He got a go-kart and a chainsaw for his, so I might try that. I remember back in college, I made love to this girl, 300 pounds. I never seen something that huge. Her elbow had a camel toe. I ain't making that up here. Hey, that is true. That is not a made-up joke. That is not a made-up joke. And I met her on an internet overweight dating service, craftsingles.com. And but we get done making lunch. She go, boy, I love that bed we was on. Was that a Tempur-Pedic bed? Because it conformed right to the shape of my body. I mean, I sunk into that bed. I'm like, we was on the floor. But I tell you, the girl that broke my heart, she busted me up good. This girl was beautiful, could have been a model. But she had tattoos from the neck down. I ain't into tattoos. Covered. Why would she do that? She was gorgeous. And just covered. Turns out she lied to me. She wasn't even good looking. She had a tattoo of a pretty girl's face on her face the whole time. Pissed me off. But I'm married now, so that's all in the past. I'm going to tell you something. My wife, I love her today. She's my best friend in the whole world. And she, well, thank you. But I will say this. I will say this. I was mad at her last night because she didn't want to make love to me. And then I informed her I still had some rollover minutes. So, do that. She's pretty spontaneous, too. One time she tied my ankles to the bedpost and tied my wrist to the bedpost, and then she left, and the store manager had to untie me out there, pissed me off. Guess they don't let you get kinky to JCPenney anymore, I guess. But I love her to death. We've been married 4 years. We've only fought one time in our entire life, and that was at Easter last year. But that was my fault, because I hold my farts in for Lent. So, Easter's not a lot of fun around our house. I've been always. You know what kills me at Easter? Them daggum peeps. Them marshmallow peeps. Good Lord. You ever eat a peep? Oh, you ever poop a peep? You ever did that? That's like pulling taffy. That ain't good at all, pooping a peep. Well, I wonder if the pips ever pooped a peep. What the hell am I talking about? You get the feeling I could do this show without anybody at all in here right now? What the hell's wrong with me? I like the Costco, too. You can buy everything at Costco in bulk. I actually go to Costco and look at that store. I actually come across a 60-pound container of raisins at the Costco. You know somebody's buying it. Like there's some dude walking around in there. You gotta be kidding me. Like before he left the house, his wife was like, hey, you see a shit pile of raisins, pick them up, will you? Then I seen a woman with a 50-gallon container of KY jelly walking around in there. She's either got problems or she's gonna be on YouTube the next day. I can't figure it out. I like to do that too when I go to Costco. I like to buy stuff just to freak out the cashier. Get you two big old jugs of KY jelly and about 900 cocktail weenies. Walk up there, that's it. The in-laws are coming over, they like to party. You know what I mean? What the hell? I always go to Costco, get my regular three crates of underbreeches up there. Oh, boy, us fellas, we can ruin some britches, can't we? I don't understand how you women keep your underbritches so daggone clean. I mean, we use the same soap, the same water, the same wash rags. What the hell? You must sneak out of the house at night and wipe with steel wool and a wet nap or something. It is the strangest thing to me. My wife will get up in the morning, take a shower, put on a fresh pair of white cotton underpants, go outside, ride the horse for an hour and a half, jog for an hour, get on the treadmill for 40 minutes, do sit-ups and push-ups in a mud puddle, take her underbritches off. They're as white as the second she put them daggum things on. I'll get up, take a shower, put on a fresh pair of underbritches, sit on a couch, bend over, put on a pair of socks. Looks like I sat on a brownie, for God's sake. I don't get it. I asked a kid at Costco about it, and he said, "Oh, I don't like it." All right.